Honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. Bhoota Singh Sidhu, Guest of Honor Principal Sajit Singh, Respected Retired Teachers of this College, Principal DAV Public School Bathinda, and my dear colleagues, good afternoon. Today is a big day for DAV College Bathinda as we are inaugurated two important and much needed projects for the betterment of our students. On this great occasion, on behalf of the management, staff and students of DAV College Bathinda, I extend my heartiest welcome to Dr. Bhoota Singh Sidhu, Vice Chancellor, MRS, Punjab Technical University, Bathinda, and thank him for sparing his valuable time out of the schedule. Thank you, sir. Ever since we got these two projects completed, I had an inner desire to get them inaugurated from some great academician rather than some politician or a bureaucrat. And today my desire is got fulfilled when we have amongst us a great academician in the field of science and technology. It is due to his continuous earn for knowledge and research that Dr. Bhoota Singh to rise from a position of an assistant professor to that of a vice chancellor of a prestigious technical university of India. He is a very simple and humble personality, and I thank him for accepting our invitation at the first instance. I also welcome our guest of honor, Dr. Sarjeet Singh, Principal Government Rajendra College Bathinda, a well-known personality in the sphere of physical education and sports. It is due to his dedication, hard work and passion for sports that Government Rajendra College Bathinda has always remained at the forefront of sports activities over the entire spectrum of Punjab University, Patiala. Since the year 1991, I have got several chances to perform my university exam duties under his leadership as a center superintendent. If I was given a chance to judge, I would have declared him as the best central superintendent for conducting university exams due to his special skills and knowledge. I welcome Principal DAV Public School Bathinda, our sister concern, who is amongst us on this occasion. I also welcome my most respected elder brothers and sisters, I mean our retired teaching staff, who are present on this occasion in a big number and are always ready to provide us any type of sincere advice in case of need for the betterment of their own institution. I am proud that our retired teaching staff have a great passion and interest in the upliftment of this institution even after their retirement. After a cutthroat competition among various colleges, our college was selected for the Star College Scheme by Department of Biotechnology, Government of India, New Delhi, and granted an aid of ₹44 lakh to be spent over the period of 3 years. I congratulate Dr. Kulwinder Singh Mann, the coordinator of the Star College team, and his entire team for their fruitful efforts in this regard. There is hardly any week when I do not find some activity in the college under the banner of DBT scheme. I am sure that the continuous efforts of DBT team will bring laurels to our college. The air conditioning of library reading hall was long pending demand of our students due to acute hot weather in the summer season, and today I feel delighted that their long pending demand is fulfilled. Here I will be failing in my duty if I do not mention the name of our former principal, Dr. Sanjeev Sharma, with whose great vision, leadership, hard work and persuasion our college was selected for the implementation of the Star College scheme. It is also due to his effort that Sardar G.S. Kangar, the then Power Minister of Government of Punjab, sanctioned the grant of ₹5 lakh for the modernization and air conditioning of the library reading hall. I salute him for this cause. I would also like to mention the name of Professor Vikas Kadia, Associate Professor, PG Department of Commerce and Management, and our State Officer, who worked day and night to complete these two projects within a allotted time. So I thank our state officer and his entire team for their dedicated work. Lastly, I welcome all my teaching and non-teaching staff present here, without whose dedicated effort this event would not have been possible. Thank you very much.
The Department of Biotechnology under the Ministry of Science and Technology, Government of India, has awarded the Star College Scheme to DAV College, Bathinda. Under this scheme, a grant of rupees 44 lakhs has been sanctioned to two science departments, physics and chemistry, as strengthening component for the implementing practical and research-based teaching and learning. For demonstrating the important laws of physics, a state-of-the-art innovation hub has been set up in the Department of Physics. An innovation hub is a place which provides facilities to nurture new ideas and help develop inquisitive perspective in youths of today. These hubs serve as springboards for new ideas and innovation, and thus help the society and economy to face future challenges and meet the rising aspirations of the growing population. I now invite Dr. Kulbinder Mann to enlighten our audience about the same.
सब तो पहला मैं पंजाबी सारे सत श्रीकाल कहना चाहना है ते सर ने मैंने इंडिकेट किया कि थोड़े टाइम च बोलना है तो मैं बैठा एक गल सोच रहा मैं बोल के जाऊंगा क्योंकि उस तो बिना तो मेरा ये दिन चल सर गल सारे यार इन्ना जरा टाइम औखा टाइम असं देखा सब ने उस तो बाद बहुत टाइम बाद फंक्शन हो रहा इस तरह का तो दिल च बड़ी खुशी भी है तो प्रवीण सर का मैं थैंक्स इस करके करना चाहूँगा क्योंकि अगर तीन चीज़ा सर ने जिड़िया कंप्लीट की इनोवेशन हब असी इस्टैबलिश की लाइब्रेरी हॉल तो एंड तीसरी जी इंपॉर्टेंट है जी शायद किसी ने पॉइंट आउट नहीं की जो सा प्लेग्राउंड है जोड़ा बहुत ही वधिया तरीके बन के तैयार हो गया है सो थैंक यू वेरी मच सो मैं विद इन 3 or 4 minutes मैं कंप्लीट कर दूंगा So, most esteemed Chief Guest Professor Dr. B.S. Sudhir, Vice Chancellor of Maharaja Ranjit Singh, Punjab Technical University, Bathinda, Chairman Dr. K.P. Nauriya Ji, Guest of Honor Dr. Sujit Singh, Principal Government Indira College, Bathinda, Officiating Principal Shri Praveen Kumar Ji, Retired Staff Members, Registrar and IQAC Coordinator Dr. Kusum Gupta Ji, Staff Secretary श्री पवन कुमार जी हेड ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट्स ऑफ ऑल द डिपार्टमेंट्स स्टेट ऑफिसर प्रोफेसर विकास कांडिया जी स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बोथ ऑफिसेस अकाउंट्स एंड जनरल ऑफिस श्री बी के शर्मा जी एंड श्री राजेंद्र जी एंड ऑल माय कलीग्स एंड एवरीवन प्रेजेंट हियर वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू It is a matter of honor for me to speak before such a learned audience about the DVT Star College scheme. This scheme is for strengthening component for UG science departments. Both physics and chemistry departments of our college have been covered under Star College scheme. I would like to explain about the basic aim and objectives of this scheme. So the basic aim of this scheme is to fill the gap caused by missed practical training up to plus two level. As all we know that how the practicals are conducted up to plus two level. So from the gap, I mean the lack of practical training that is missed among the students that are going to take admission in BSc. So I want to share one fact with you. Every parent want to make his or her kid either engineer or doctor. And this unrealistic wish creates a very hard competition after plus two. Thus, majority of students have to appear for two important exams. One is JEE, other is NEET. From the successful students, on an average, 30% of students get admission in reputed colleges. But 70% students feel rejected or their failure. About 50% from this 70%, that is 35% students, get admission in other reputed colleges also. But remaining 35 students, 25% students wants to go abroad, and we get only 10% students to get admission in BSc. And all these students feel hopeless cases. Moreover, they do not have any practical training which is mandatory or expected before taking admission in BSc as per the prescribed syllabus of the universities. Thus, majority students lose their interest in science studies. So, our first and the foremost duty is to revive their lost interest in sciences. Then, provided them required practical training to fill the gap, so that after completing their graduations, they can compete at the global level. In the year 2008, DBT, Department of Biotechnology, Ministry of Science and Technology, has started to provide financial support to colleges with well-qualified science staff. This strengthening grant aims to enrich science labs and libraries with multiple copies of equipment and books to provide quality science education and training to students, so that these students will choose science as their career and pursue higher studies in sciences. So the objective of this scheme can be abbreviated in 5 words, that is SMART, S-M-A-R-T. So S for strengthening of labs and library, M motivating students for hands-on practical training, A augmentation of interdisciplinary activities, R refinement and repair of existing lab equipments, T for training for lab staff and students. To achieve these objectives, our faculty members of physics and chemistry departments are putting their best efforts. We have organized many online activities like webinars, online poster making competitions, virtual lab trainings, virtual lab visits, ESOPs, and create journals club and set up innovation hub for live demonstrations of physics principles. This innovation hub contains 25 physics demonstrations related to theory taught at UG level. With each demonstration, many experiments can be performed. This hub has been established with the help of Professor YK Vijay, retired VC of Jaipur University, and in collaboration with IAPT, that is Indian Association of Physics Teachers. All demonstrations are focused on inculcating students' interest in sciences and making it easier for students to understand various concepts of physics in a playful way. So, it is my open invitation to all the individuals for visiting the Innovation Hub of our department. Thank you for your patience. Thank you very much.